Hi, I'm Tom Lu. Today, I'm in Bryce Canyon National Park. Bryce Canyon National Park is located in the southwest of Utah. With a size of 35,000 acres, Bryce Canyon is a relatively small national park in the United States. Technically not a canyon, Bryce Canyon is situated on the side of a plateau, featuring a large collection of natural spires of vibrant colors, known as hoodoos, a very unique geological structure. Today, we are going to explore Bryce Canyon National Park. When you hike down the amphitheater in Bryce Canyon National Park, you are entering a geological fairyland. Yes, it's a natural wonder. Specifically, it's a natural wonder made of the red sandstone of American Southwest. Moreover, it's a natural wonder that creates a sense of childhood fantasy. A labyrinth of meandering hiking trails, miles and miles, surrounded by tall rock walls, soaring spires, steep cliffs and tunnels. You can never anticipate what you will see in the next few moments, or a few steps away. Things here certainly look beautiful, but they are not beautiful in a normal sense. They look strange. They look out of ordinary. It's like a vast maze in an American amusement park, except that it was actually created by nature. The experience is intimate, adventurous, and exciting. When you look at the distance, you will see the red sprawling mountainous terrain dotted with endless green pine trees from here to beyond. Some of these trees are over 500 years old. They look particularly vital, potent, and defiant of harsh climate conditions. The contrast of the colors, primarily red and green, makes the landscape look even more fascinating. You have to be here, see it, in order to believe it. You can't help wondering how everything came into being here. Why here? When you see something that you like, it's important to know where it came from. Before this area was full of natural spires or hoodoos, it was full of water. Between 55 and 40 million years ago, today's Utah was a mountain-encircled basin with ancient lakes. Rivers deposited sediments into the lakes over millions of years. As the Colorado Plateau began to rise, the lakes dried up, and their mixture of sediments became muddy limestone, a process called clarion formation, named after one of the ancient lakes in the area, Lake Clarion. Small organisms, like snails, fed in the muddy limestone, adding their calcareous skeletons to the detritus upon their death. Combined with iron, oxygen, and water in the sediment, rusting many of the layers into warm red, orange, and pink hues. Eventually, the ancient lakes evaporated entirely as Earth became warmer, exposing the intricate and vibrantly colored layers of sediments from the bottom of the lakes. This is what we see at Bryce Canyon today. The spires at Bryce Canyon were shaped by weathering and erosion. As snow and ice melt, water seeps into fractures. As it refreezes, it expands and cracks the rock around it. This process, called frost wedging, plays a significant role in creating spires at Bryce Canyon. The spires are eroded out of the cliffs where rows of narrow walls form. These thin rock walls are called fins. Frost wedging enlarges cracks in the fins, creating holes or windows,
As the windows grow, their tops eventually collapse, leaving a column. Rain further dissolves and sculpts these limestone pillars into bulbous spires called hoodoos. The delicate climatic balance between snow and rain ensures that new hoodoos will emerge while old ones become reduced to lumps of clay. Bryce Canyon sits on the edge of the Pasagunt Plateau, which was formed 10 to 20 million years ago by the uplift on the larger Colorado Plateau. Massive tectonic plate activity from 20 to 15 million years ago pushed up a tremendous swath of Earth's crust, eventually raising the region nearly 2 miles, forming the 130,000 square mile Colorado Plateau. Bryce Canyon also happens to be part of the Grand Staircase, a vast and a rugged landscape in American Southwest. The Grand Staircase is made of multiple layers of sedimentary rocks, stretching from the Bryce Canyon in the highest north to the Grand Canyon in the lowest south. Between them, there are striking geological features and a diverse landscape. These layers appear to step down across the landscape, resembling a giant natural staircase. The Grand Staircase is so massive that its pattern of downward layers can only be seen from the space or high altitude in the air. Layers of rock, spires, and trees at Bryce Canyon are strikingly beautiful. They also serve as the chapters in a huge history book that describe how Earth developed. The Grand Staircase, which is home to Bryce Canyon and many other natural wonders, is America's largest and the richest geological treasure.